What band did you bring along this time?
Well, most of the guys used to be the Push band. Ernie McCone and Crispin Taylor, who is just, I mean, he is so steady. It's like once he sets the tempo, even if I want to change it, nah, that's it. Yeah, and we have the Finn Peters on horns and Mike Gorman and Mark Vandergoot on the guitar.
But this tour is especially rough, you tell me, right?
Yeah, it is. Well, the travel and the time off is just not sufficient for me. So, and I tell you the truth, there's some, the guys are younger than me, but I noticed that there was a lot of dragging.
How is the tour so far, except for the traveling? Is playing still nice?
Oh, well, yeah. I mean, I still enjoy the music, absolutely. When my voice is holding up, you know. So far, it's been pretty good. Just one night, you know, where I wanted to choke somebody, and I'm not going to tell you what night it was.
You wanted to choke who?
Yeah, right.
I mean, we're glad you're still on tour. It's a big tour, right? I mean, you do a lot of gigs.
A lot, yes, absolutely. But, you know, I have been touring for 50 years, so, you know, I haven't been taking as much time off as I thought I was going to. But I promised my husband, and this time I'm really going to take like 2 months and then I'll work and then 2 months and work, you know, before going back to Japan in November. So
you're never tired of touring and playing because, like you said, it's been 50 years almost.
Well, the one thing I think that kind of keeps me fresh, or at least it keeps me balanced, is the fact that I do so many different styles of music. So, you know, when I'm with this band, it's this kind. It's the R&B and the what they used to call urban contemporary. Who knows, you know? My God, I've outplayed the labels.
Did you?
I mean, gee. And then I'll be with the UNLV big band. I do, I try to do as much work as I can with the university band. And it's always kind of interesting to see the kids every 4 years, you know, changing and how the sound changes. And also I've been working with Diva, the all-female jazz orchestra.
Wow, how's that?
Yeah, oh, it's great. You know, we just recorded let's put it the right way. I did two or three songs on their album while I was at the Lincoln Center in New York. So,
wow.
Yeah. So that's kind of, you know, it's kind of interesting. Although when I'm in the middle of it, you know, I'm steadily. Can I say bitching? Yeah. I am bitching constantly. You know, where's that music? Who put that thing over there? You know, it's always somebody else's fault. I love having kids, you know. Somebody to blame.
You brought this up yourself. You saw the whole music industry change. You witnessed the art, quote-unquote, of sampling coming up.
Yes.
And there must have been a moment in time when you heard your own voice sampled by somebody else. How was that?
I think it's great.
Yeah.
I really do. Number one, I love the surprise of it and like to hear what, you know, what somebody else's idea is. But this kind of makes me feel like I'm the sun, you know, and I shine on all kinds of things, you know.
You are.
Yes, wheat, good stuff, you know, that grows. And as I told somebody the other day, and don't forget nuts, you know, so there's some of that growing out there too. Some I'm not particularly pleased with, but you know, everything is fine. You know, God bless me, I'm...
There are a lot of people who actually know your voice, but not know that it's you. There was a big hit in Europe by Blue Boy, for instance.
Yes.
It was a huge hit. Only today I figured out it was you, actually.
Are you serious? Really?
Yeah.
The funny part about I knew that it was going to come out because I had already been contacted and the publishing company had been contacted. But I was actually sitting in my home watching the football playoffs, and I happened to be alone, and all of a sudden I heard, "I want you to get together. I want you to get together." It's like,
who is this lady?
You know, what's going on? And the blood just rushed from my head, you know. And I heard my doorbell, front doorbell ring, and I saw my son standing out there, and he's pointing because he can see me through the window, you know, and I'm pointing at the television. And he's saying, this woman has finally gone off her nut, you know. Wow. So, yeah, and then he came in and he said, well, but mommy, I've been hearing that, you know, for weeks. And he explained to me where he heard it.
Yeah.
So it's kind of interesting and it's exciting, sure. Not to mention, it's been very lucrative, you know, very lucrative.
You get paid for that? Because that's the other question I was thinking about.
Yes, oh yes.
More than often, people, artists, don't get their money, right?
Yeah. And I'm quite sure, you know, there's still lots out there. But let's face it, I've got the Sound Exchange, I've got BMI, I've got Bug Music, I've got about four people collecting, you know.
You're doing all right.
Well, yeah, I'm not concerned, you know. Somehow, I've just always felt very blessed. I don't know why. It's like even when I want to mess up, it's the God just makes the plan that no, you won't mess up. Like today, for example, you know.
I was actually wondering about that because you had a lot of lapses in your career where things went differently than you expected. You did some tests for famous producers, and some of them you failed, and others you didn't. But you always picked up the pace and evolved and started another career and another.
Are you talking about the movie?
Yeah, or
change
styles or?
Well, no. I mean, I went to audition for The Color Purple or something like that, but. I mean, my goodness, I learned that they were looking for me 2 days before they asked me to come in for it. So, I wasn't really prepared. I had read the book, the funny part about it, I certainly had. And I loved, I like the end result of the story.
Yeah.
But I would have found it difficult to be in that character,
yeah.
And I'm forget exactly which character it was, but you know what? After having such success with, I think it was, who was a Go Away Little Boy? I mean, that was the really instant. Although of course I'd been working before, and I called up the agency and I said, "What's going on? You know, I haven't heard from you." And he said, "Well, Marlena, you know." That record has only sold like 125,000 as of now, you know, and that's like 2 weeks or something. And I got on the telephone and I started calling clubs that I had worked, and I, you know, and I'm saying, "Hi, this is Marlena Shaw," and you get that sudden quiet on the other end, you know, the guy died, he said. But that has been my saving grace, has been working live. And I really consistently worked live. All kinds of venues, the big bands, the small bands.
Why do you do that?
Yeah, because I love it.